here at the Stockwood Park Athletics Track. I've got a short workout today. It's the first time I've been on the track since it's opened again. So I've got a tempo workout, which is about an hour long. I've just warmed up, just done a 10 minute warm up in zone two. I've got 10 minutes in zone three, 2 minute recovery, 10 minutes in zone three, 2 minute recovery. In total, we've got four of those. And then to finish off, it'll just be a 10 minute warm up. So an hour workout, and then I'll be back to work. So we'll see you on the track. So we did 10 minute warm up, four sets of tempo running. So not going above 165 beats per minute in terms of heart rate, 2 minute rests, and then just a warm down. It's the first time I've ran in the heat this year. I'm not quite sure what the temperature is, but certainly I could feel that when I was on the track. I felt good really overall. Moderate intensity, overall, so wasn't too bad. I'm certainly feeling a little bit of fatigue in my calves, and had my bike fit last week, so I am wondering whether I'm certainly feeling my calves a little bit more on the bike, so I do wonder whether the tweaks made have loaded up my calves a little bit more, because I wouldn't necessarily expect to be carrying fatigue in my calves. I haven't ran since Saturday, so I might have to play with that position. And I'm going to be resting from running and cycling tomorrow and just swimming, so that's going to hopefully help my legs recover. But other than that, I felt pretty good, a little bit of heart rate creep in the first couple of sets, but probably due to fatigue. But as I warmed up into the workout, it got better. This morning, I also swam, done some technical swimming, done about 1200 meters. So all in all, good day of training. And more to come. So it's 7:45 in the morning. I've just got back from a long run, 20.2 miles, average pace of 7 minutes 53 per mile. That's the longest run I've done so far this year in my training. It's, like I say, it's 7:45 in the morning. So I was up nice and early, out just after 5. And I woke up this morning feeling a little bit sluggish, I'm not going to lie. Didn't particularly want to get out of bed, but once I got a coffee down me and some water, I started feeling okay. Got out on the run, and heart rate was okay whilst I was running. Average heart rate, 160 beats per minute. Ideally, I'd like to bring that down. Now, the pace that I ran at was slightly faster than the pace I'm going to be running at for Ironman. So aiming for a 8 minute mile pace on the marathon for Ironman, which will bring me in 3:30, or somewhere between there, 3:30 and 3:45. So slightly faster today, but like I said, I didn't feel too clever when I got out there. My legs were heavy, quads especially. I think potentially I was a little bit sore from the long cycle I did earlier in the week. I didn't do too much training yesterday, just a bit of resistance work, so it wouldn't have been any soreness from that. But yeah, potentially it was that. But happy, really. Good run. Good to get out, get it done in the morning, and I look forward to the next long run, definitely. We'll see you soon. So we've just driven up to Northampton, and we're going to a place called Swimcube, which is essentially a swimming pool with like a current that you swim into. It's almost like a pool that never ends. And I'm going to see a guy up there who's going to break down my technique. I've been up here before twice, last year, but I haven't been up here since the swimming pool's reopened a couple of weeks ago. So it's going to be good to see where my technique's at compared to where it was last year. I'm definitely faster in the water, but I do feel very inefficient at times, especially when I start getting fatigued. So we're going to try and figure that out. Yeah, it's going to be fun. We'll catch up afterwards and talk about how it went.
do that.
So we have just got done swimming at the swimcube with Stuart Hacker, and I'm buzzing, to be honest. Like, every time, I always forget. I've only been there twice previously, and that was the later part of last year. Then obviously because of the lockdowns and stuff like that, we couldn't swim, and I've just gone back there today. But I always forget how much my swimming like transforms in a single session at the swimcube. So today we worked on head position again, which is always a factor for me, rotation, my entry into the water as well, and then rotating from that position. What else did we do? We did some stuff on breathing, and I'm looking forward to getting in the pool and drilling some of this stuff. I'm due to see Stuart again in a couple of weeks' time, and we'll see how I'm feeling when I get back in there. But like I say, it's like, it's one of those things where I'm just not a swimmer naturally by nature. You know, when I was younger, I was pretty rubbish at swimming. I only really picked it up in the, you know, last year or so, and actually started to work on my technique and stuff like that. To be honest, you know, a year and a half ago, I couldn't swim 25 meters without feeling like I was drowning. So now I'm, you know, feeling pretty comfortable in the water. And yeah, just like literally, like because it's a, the swim cube's like a endless pool essentially with a current you swim into, and you can kind of like turn the speed up and dial it back down as you're progressing with your swimming and as you're like working through different things. So he kind of set it at one pace to start off with, but as he starts making tweaks, what I naturally noticed is, if I kept looking up at the pace, he's like creeping the pace down, so I'm speeding up naturally, and the level of exertion is like, you know, much reduced. So I mean, that is hopeful, you know. And I've kind of set myself a goal for Ironman to try and get a sub 1 hour swim, and it's a massive stretch goal for me. I'm like, it don't seem that fast for a lot of people, but for me that's going to be challenging. So if I can keep making improvements like I am at the moment, bearing in mind I've done very little swimming, so now, you know, over the last couple of weeks I've managed to get a couple sessions in a week, and from this point onwards I'm going to try to aim to get 2 to 3 sessions a week of swimming. If I can keep making improvements up until the 4th of July, I think we might be on for it. I'll catch you soon.